The whole football community was shocked to hear of the passing of Richard Henyakane in the early hours of April 7th this year. But none more so than his former teammates in Sundowns and former Golden Arrows coach Mangoba Mangeti.
It was saddening, man, considering that we had just buried his brother in December, and not even 5 months later, Richard also passes away. Based on the fact that I worked with both these boys, it became very difficult for me to be able to handle the situation.
When I heard about the passing on of Richie, it was unbelievable. We spent a lot of time with him in this lab. You start thinking about the memories, the good time that we had with him. You said, no, it can't be. And it was just a happy song. Really, really saddening.
Yes, to me it's a big loss, and obviously at first it was something that came as a shock. I couldn't believe that he's gone until I saw on the news. To me, Richard, he was not just a teammate, he was also my friend. We used to go out together. I used to go to his house, he used to come to my place, and I lost the brother. It was so good to me, it was so good to him.
One thing I can say about Richard, he was exceptionally quick, lightning quick, which is why many people ended up calling him the Kimberley Express, because of his feet. When I arrived at Arrows, he was playing as a winger for four to five seasons. Then I changed him into a striker because I saw that for us as a smaller team, it would really benefit us to have somebody as quick as him in our counter-attacking game. And in his first season, he did wonders because over the past 4 years, he had not scored more than 4 goals in the team. But in one season, when I converted him into a striker, he scored 19 goals in the league and he became the top goal scorer. He was very committed to this game and he was a great crosser of the ball. That's why many coaches used him as a winger. But he had a very good first touch and could clear himself easily from defenders, because after that first touch you would know there was lightning speed following, and he could kick the ball very well, which made him a very, very useful striker for us.
He was a handful, and you should ask the defenders during that season. He was a handful, and the type of football, especially with Arrows, the way they were playing, and obviously with the guys he was playing with at Arrows, they knew his potential, they knew his strong point, and which was the pace. The finishing also was superb, because you find players that are very fast, but when they get to where it matters, next to the post, they don't convert those chances. But Richard Ziwan was one of the players that he was quick, and his finishing was very good also.
A fantastic player. I enjoyed all the games I've played with him in the same team and playing against him while he was also still at Golden Arrows. He's really quick throughout his whole career. You'd see that he probably got a lot of offside only because of the speed. Sometimes he would never know when to hold his run. He would just go. But it was just a God-given talent. You know, Richard was one of the quickest strikers in the PSL, and he gave defenders a hard time. He surely missed not only in Kimberley but throughout South Africa.
A very big loss, I must say, because we always hope that from these young men we will get legends, and these legends are going to become the teachers of the game in the years to come. And when you lose these players that at some unique skill which would be respected and be honored by their societies and by the younger coming players that are still aspiring to become top players, when you lose those players you end up not having these role models, these characters that younger boys would always want to refer to and say, I would want to be like Richard Henyakane, I would want to be like Joseph Henyakane. So it becomes a very, very big loss when you lose a role model because there aren't many.
In football as a whole, South Africa as a whole, we really lost a good player. We really lost a friend, a brother, his family. They must also know that they are not on their own. We also feel the void that he has left. We just pray that God can give them the strength to carry on and move on. It's not easy, but they are not the only one who lost Richard. We also felt the pain.
I say to his family, stay strong. Oh, we are no one to actually judge on what has happened. Only God knows why this had to happen. And let us learn from what Richard has left.